When you are emotionally detoxifying, it may be necessary to cry. You may feel the desire to curl up in the fetus shape, laying upon your side. There are many different symptoms that you can have during this emotional detoxification. And this is a sign during your meditation that you are releasing stored emotional patterns within you. Allow it to happen as nature guides it to. Your egoic mind cannot control this process. Trying to control it is based upon fear and not trusting it. That is a root chakra issue. Inability to trust in God, trying to control all your experience, is a root chakra imbalance of the earth element and one of the earliest traumas that happens in the human being. The deepest emotional traumas are stored in the root chakra as well, because they happened at the earliest years of our life. As a human being, our consciousness naturally evolves through the different chakras as we age and grow. And so emotional fasting happens in meditation as we stay as the awareness and allow the emotional body to come to stillness. The skill in meditation is learning how to stay as the awareness and not to become identified with the emotions you are feeling. You must learn to watch them and just allow them to be present. You must not try to control them. You must not believe that they are you or that they can harm you in any way. By staying as this deeper consciousness, you are breaking the control that the emotional body has over you, that the ego part of your emotional body has over you. In the end, when you are awakened and when your emotional body is purified, you will have full 100% control of your entire emotional energy system, including the functioning of all your chakras. What this means is that you will no longer react to this world in any emotional way. You will always have peace. And if you desire in that moment to feel an emotion or to express an emotion, then you can do so, for you will have conscious mastery over your emotional body. Meditation, true meditation, staying as the awareness behind it all, will deliver you to the state. Other forms that may have been called meditation by human beings that do involve using the mind to control things will not give you this result. Meditation is only, in our definition, that which is the state of staying as the observer, the awareness that is behind it all, that is looking out through the mind, body, and emotions. Now, dear ones, as you go more deeply within yourself, you will see that your emotions are tied to beliefs and to memories. These are stored within the mental body. It is these deepest beliefs and memories that control the emotional responses that you feel. As you are working to purify your emotions, you are also purifying your mind, for the two are intimately related as your personal being. There are deeper layers within the mental body as well that relate to more of a non-human experience, a universal state, but we will not discuss those at this time, for the focus of this video is human transformation, human understanding, and human evolution. For you have chosen to incarnate to be a human and to experience this human lifetime, and so we will keep our focus here. As you work to create stillness in your emotions, you are also creating stillness in your thoughts. It is the thoughts that you hear within your mind that are signposts pointing to the deeper memories and beliefs that you have within you. Understand that the mind is far deeper than just audible thought. The thought is that which happens on the surface, but it is not the depth of that which you are in your mental body. The thoughts are often related to the physical and emotional body, and also to the deepest mental impressions, the energetic patterns stored in our mental body. You will find in your meditation that as you deepen, you will increase the silence between your thoughts, the rate, the speed at which your thoughts happen in your conscious mind will be decreasing, and the volume at which your thoughts speak in your mind will also decrease. These are the three signs of evidence that you are purifying and stilling the layers of your mind. You will notice that during heightened emotional states, your thoughts race. They speak most quickly. Your thoughts are loud. They pull your awareness into your thoughts most deeply. And during states of peace, it is the opposite. Your thoughts quiet. Slow down, and eventually more and more silence happens between each thought, and more silence grows within the thought as well. You will have incomplete thoughts. As you deepen in meditation, you may hear a few words that then stop and fall back into silence. This is like the momentum of your thinking mind slowing down and stopping. Stay as the awareness and allow it to slow and stop. And when new thoughts arise, if you get pulled into them, return back to the awareness. Allow them to slow and stop. During this process of meditation and observation of the mental body, you will see the patterns of your karma. But what you will also see is the deeper spiritual consciousness that you are. During this process, a break will happen. It is the break between your spiritual self and your human ego, that is the subject of your thoughts. Your thoughts think about this false self. This is the ego. It is the idea of you, but it is not the deepest you that is the silence. The deepest you cannot be thought about because it has no content. That which the ego thinks about is not you, because it is an idea built upon an idea, built upon another idea, and on it goes from your early childhood years. Ideas about who you are growing, being built upon by new ideas, and so the ego structure is designed. But the true you has no form. When you live as the true you, the deepest spiritual consciousness, there is only silence and stillness. It has no form. And so it is our minds that invent an idea of ourself. And this idea comes from how the world, society, our parents, our friends, our family, our loved ones, all taught us to be. But you are beyond this.